You know, your Bambu Lab A1 or A1 Mini plays music on its motors. You hear it when you turn the printer on, when you start a print job, and when a print job finishes. But did you know you can make your own music on it? Well, you can. And today on the BB3D channel, we'll see how to do exactly that. I'm Brian, and you are watching BB3D. This video is sponsored by PCBWay. PCBWay is known for making low-cost, high-quality printed circuit boards, but they also do CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, and even injection molding. They sent me a few samples, and I gotta say, these circuit board rulers and coasters are freaking amazing. And the clear resin prints of the PCBWay logo, these are 100% crystal clear. So whether you need PCBs, machining services, or even something printed in a specialty material your printer can't handle, PCBWay can do that for you. Check them out at PCBWay.com. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Okay, so today we're finding out how to make music with the Bambu Lab A1 or A1 Mini. Back when the A1 Mini was released, and we heard it playing its little tunes, Bambu Lab hinted there would be a tool to allow us to create our own. And now there is. It lives at midi2gcode.bambulab.com, and for convenience, there's a link in the description. It's a full MIDI player and editor, and it can export MIDI files to Gcode that the printer can play back on its motors, and it's free. Before we get into making some sort of music with this, there are some limitations you need to be aware of. The A1 and the A1 Mini use their X, Y, and Z motors to play the notes. And since they have exactly one each of these motors, the printers can play at most three notes at the same time. This is useful when creating chords, for example, but that also means you can't just load up a 15-track MIDI file and dump it to Gcode and have it sound good. Even a simple one-track MIDI file could have several notes being played at the same time. So while this tool can import a MIDI file and you can save it as Gcode, the chances of it sounding decent are somewhat low. A better way, then, is to build up a song in the editor from scratch. You could either do this by ear, placing notes and moving them around as you like, or you could transcribe sheet music if you're really serious about it. Also, shorter is probably better, at least if you want to replace the start a print and print is done tunes. So let's do something simple for a start print tune. Maybe that charge thing they play at sports ball games to get the fans excited. You know the one. Well, this will get you excited because your printer is about to make something for you. I mean, hopefully it makes the thing you want instead of a big plate of spaghetti. But either way, it's making something. So, over at Bambu Lab's music editing site, we're starting with a new song file. Anywhere you click in here, it'll add a note and it'll play it at the same time. By the way, if you click and add a note and it's in the wrong place, you can drag it around to where you need it, and you can also drag to set its duration. If you accidentally click and place a note that you don't want at all, you can, while it's still highlighted in white, press the backspace or the delete key on your keyboard to get rid of it. Fortunately, this little tune is only 6 notes long, so there's not a lot of mistakes that can creep in. I'll click here to add the first note. This is a G. Then here to add a C. Then an E. Another G, an octave higher than the first one, and that needs to be a little bit longer, so I'll stretch that one out. Then back down to E, and back up to G, and even longer. And from experimentation, a tempo of 200 beats per minute is about what this needs, so I'll set that too. Notice that none of these notes overlap one another. That's good, because if you have overlapping notes on the same channel, there's no telling which of them is going to get played. Remember, each motor can only play one note at a time. I'll show an example of multiple channels in just a bit. When adding notes, the instrument is set to acoustic grand piano, and you can set that to whatever you like from its list of instruments, but it doesn't matter what instrument you've got selected, it's just going to be a motor making a beep sound. So don't expect the printer to sound like a high-fidelity acoustic grand piano. To listen to the song in the editor, use the playback controls at the bottom of the page. The play arrow plays the song, and the stop square stops playback and resets the playhead to the beginning. If you need to make adjustments, make sure playback is stopped, drag the notes where you want them, and then play it back again to make sure it sounds the way you expected. Eventually, you're going to want to export this so the printer can play it. But before it can be exported for the printer, the tracks, track 1 in this case, needs to be assigned to a motor. To see where that's done, click this triangle next to track 1. Now you'll see a list of all the tracks in this song and what they're assigned to. Right now, track 1 isn't assigned to anything. Clicking here will allow you to pick chord, bass, or main theme. Now, I don't know which one maps to which motor, but I do know that you have to pick one, so I'll pick chord because it's the first one in the list. I think this would be more self-explanatory if Bambu Lab changed these labels to motor 1, motor 2, and motor 3. Maybe they will in the future. The first few times I was trying to do this, I was running into trouble because I didn't know I had to assign tracks to motors and the printer wouldn't make any sound when I tried playing the files. Well, now let's take a look at a slightly more complex example. Here is a simple multi-track MIDI that I put together, and it plays multiple notes at the same time. I have 3 channels on it. Notably, each channel's tones overlap with the other ones, forming 3-note chords. I set each channel to a different color, and each channel is assigned to a different motor. Granted, it's still simplistic, but the intent is to show you that while you can play up to 3 notes at the same time, those 3 notes have to be on different channels. Let's talk about saving files in different formats. Going back to the charge tune, I'm going to save my work in case something goes wrong. And I'm going to save it as MIDI, because I'll be able to load a MIDI file into this tool again later if I want to make changes. To save, click the File menu at the top of the page, then click Save As, give the file a name, pick where to save it, and then click the Save button. Now, it's saved as a MIDI file, so I won't have to recreate this from scratch if I need it later. Next, here's how to save the file as G-code so the printer can play it. Click the File menu at the top of the page, click Save as G-code, name the file, pick where to save it, and click the Save button. Now you've got a file the printer can play. But how? Well, there are 2 ways to get the printer to play these musical masterpieces, these sonatas in G-code. Since I'm not a musician, mine are sonata masterpiece. At any rate, the first way, the easiest way, is to copy the file to a microSD card. The printer's card slot is not hot swappable, so you'll need to turn the printer off before removing or inserting the printer's card. So, printer off, remove the card, put the card in the computer, copy the file, eject the card from the computer, and then insert the card into the printer, turn the printer on, and tap Print Files. Then select the musical G-code file and let the printer play it. If the printer doesn't play the song, tap Settings. In the Print Options section, make sure the option for Sounds is turned on. Then try it again. If it still doesn't play, check to make sure you've got your tracks assigned to motors in the editor. Save it as G-code, put it on the card, and try again. So that was the first way. The second way to get music to the printer is to manually edit the printer's start and end G-code settings. And this is the method you'd use if you wanted to play a different start print and end print song. Open the music G-code in a text editor. You can use WordPad on Windows or TextEdit on macOS. Personally, I tend to use BBEdit on the Mac. So, open the musical G-code file, and I'm opening the charge file. The longer the song, the more lines of code it will contain. That's why I suggest keeping the start print and end print songs short. Select the entire contents of the file and copy it to the clipboard. With that code copied, switch over to Bambu Studio. On the Prepare tab, click the Edit button next to your printer. This opens the Printer Settings window. Make sure Advanced is turned on in the top right corner of the window to expose the Machine G-code tab. Click the Machine G-code tab to access its contents. In the Machine Start G-code field, scroll down a bit until you come to the section labeled Start Printer Sound. The Bambu Start song begins with an M17 command and ends with an M18 command. Select the text starting with the M17 all the way through the M18. Delete that, then paste the G-code for the new song. Follow the same steps to change the song played at the end of a print by deleting the original song in the machine end G-code field and pasting in a new one. I'll paste in that other little song I made, the one with the chords. The printer settings have been changed, so they need to be saved. Click the floppy disk save icon and give the printer settings a name. I'll just change the word copy at the end to new tunes and then save it as a user preset. From that point on, any file I slice using those printer settings will play the new songs at the start and the end of a print. And of course, if it gets irritating, you can switch back to the original printer preset, or you can turn off sounds entirely from the printer settings screen. So that's all there is to getting your Bambu Lab A1 or A1 Mini to change its tune. If you need more of a step-by-step written guide, there's a link in the description to a Bambu Lab Wiki page. Thanks again to PCBWay for sponsoring this video. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this episode. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something musical. Or something cool. Something music cool.